Hey, this is Dr. Matt Nejad, and in this video we'll be covering the topic of immediate dentin sealing. This includes what is immediate dentin sealing, why immediate dentin sealing is important, and also how to do immediate dentin sealing with a video demonstration that shows every step of the technique. First up, we're going to cover what is immediate dentin sealing. Simply put, immediate dentin sealing is when you seal the dentin with your dentin bonding agent on the preparation appointment, and this is in contrast to delayed dentin sealing, which we normally do, which involves bonding to dentin during the cementation visit. There's a lot of advantages to doing this immediately for all our indirect restorations, including crowns, inlays, onlays, veneers, and basically any lab-made restoration. Also, if you think about it, for every direct restoration we do, you're always doing immediate dentin sealing, but when you do indirect restorations, there's a big change, and the important thing is that doing it immediately has a lot of advantages, so we want to do that for our indirect restorations as well. Next, we're going to be covering why immediate dentin sealing is important, and there's a lot of different reasons why, but we're going to be covering the most major reasons. The most important reason is that immediate dentin sealing gives us the highest possible bond strength to dentin. In fact, the bond strength with immediate dentin sealing is so strong that it approaches the same bond that enamel has to dentin at the DEJ region, which is basically what we're trying to mimic in biomimetic dentistry. Also, freshly cut dentin is the ideal substrate to bond to, and clinically, freshly cut dentin means immediately after preparation, and this is the dentin surface that gives us the best bond strength, so we want to be bonding to our dentin right after we finished our preparation. Another advantage is that it allows stress-free bond development. What that means is once you've cured your dentin bonding agent, the bond to dentin forms gradually. It's not instantaneous. It takes some time, and during this time, you want to minimize stressing of that bond. When you do immediate dentin sealing, you're allowing at least several minutes, if not up to 1 or 2 weeks, for that bond to mature, and it does get stronger with time. The most impactful time is the first 5 to 10 minutes. Another advantage of immediate dentin sealing is that it improves the fracture resistance of our restorations. When you do immediate dentin sealing, you're not only getting a stronger bond, but you're also improving the performance of your restorative material. Another advantage of immediate dentin sealing is that pre-curing your dentin bonding agent gives you the highest possible bond strength. And if you think about it, when you do a traditional cementation, you're applying your adhesive or your self-adhesive cement, and you're trying to combine a couple steps together. But studies have shown that when you pre-cure the adhesive separately, you get the highest possible bond strength. And if you try to apply adhesive and cure on cementation day, you have to deal with the thickness of the adhesive, preventing full seating of your restoration. Lastly, another advantage of immediate dentin sealing is that it provides relief from sensitivity and discomfort during your temporization period, and also it gives you protection. When you seal the dentin, you're actually plugging the tubules, you're putting a layer on top of your dentin, so this is very resistant to bacterial leakage and the potential for cavities. Also, it provides relief from sensitivity because all the tubules are protected and sealed. So these are some really big advantages that make sure that you don't have complications during your temporization period. Now we're going to cover how to perform immediate dentin sealing with a step-by-step video demonstration. At this point, you need to make sure your preparation's completed and that you have adequate isolation in place. Adequate isolation is so important for maintaining a contamination-free working environment, free of moisture, saliva, and any sort of debris. I highly recommend the rubber dam for optimal results, and for the other products I recommend, take a look in the description below. The first step of immediate dentin sealing is priming. And during this step, the goal is to prime the entire dentin surface. And in order to do that very well, you need to make sure you don't miss any areas. So what I recommend is priming slightly past the dentin, going a little bit past the DEJ to make sure you don't miss any areas. In this demonstration, I'm using a 6th generation self-etching primer, so I don't need to etch separately. While I'm scrubbing, I'm both etching and priming the dentin, and it's okay to extend past the DEJ. After you've applied for 20 seconds, you need to air dry your solvent, and this is where it's very important to know the chemistry of the products you're using. This product uses water as a solvent, so I need to air dry for a full 10 seconds in order to evaporate all the solvent. Other systems may be using an alcohol-based solvent and they might need less time, but if you were to leave the water behind, it would create a huge problem for the developing bond and you wouldn't get the high bond strength that we're trying to achieve with this immediate dentin sealing protocol. Now that you've primed the dentin, you've begun forming the hybrid layer, and in the next step, the goal is to apply the adhesive again to just the dentin surface. During immediate dentin sealing, the goal is to focus on the dentin so you're not trying to apply anything to the enamel, but in order to make sure you don't miss any of the dentin surface, you do need to extend slightly past the DEJ. If you extend too far past and get on your enamel margins, you can always clean those up before you take your final impression. When I apply the adhesive, I like to follow up with a clean dry microbrush to wick up the excess adhesive that puddles in the most concave areas. The goal is to have a nice thin layer of adhesive in my technique because I follow with flowable resin in a step called resin coating. But if you're not gonna do this resin coating step, then you may be able to leave a thicker adhesive depending on what product you're using. Once you're ready, you go ahead and cure for 20 seconds. And as you're curing, now you're finally forming a bond to dentin. And it's important to remember that this bond does not develop instantly. Bond formation is a reaction, it's polymerization, and it takes time for it to reach its full potential. So the steps that we do after this are designed to minimize any additional stress so that the bond to dentin can form without anything opposing its full potential. After this first cure, we're ready for the step called resin coating. And during this step, what we do is we take a layer of flowable composite. You want to use something with a real high modulus or good filler content. And your goal is to cover the entire sealed dentin area with 0.5 millimeter of flowable. My approach to do this is to cover about half of the dentin surface with flowable, then take a probe and use that to drag the flowable to cover all the dentin right up to the DEJ, making sure not to miss any areas. And then I check with the probe, and your probe should have 1 millimeter markings on it so that you can verify that you have less than 1 millimeter, somewhere around 0.5 millimeter. It doesn't have to be exactly 0.5 millimeter. Your goal is somewhere between 0.2 and 0.5 millimeters. So once you have that and everything looks nice and smooth, you'd go ahead and cure a second time, and this would be completing the step called resin coating. While you're curing, again, the bond is still forming to your dentin, but what's nice about the flowable resin is that it has a lower modulus of elasticity than the following products that we will use, and it allows the bond to continue forming without any excessive stress that would minimize your bond strength to dentin. It also protects the developing dentin bond from subsequent layers that you may be doing depending on the shape and configuration of your preparation. Now that we've completed resin coating, the next step is called the biobase. So it's almost like doing a buildup, but the idea is to change the shape and deal with problem areas. This includes undercut areas, deep areas that would make it really hard to cure our final restoration, or even deep margins that we could elevate with something called the deep margin elevation technique. In this particular preparation, the only area that we need to address is on the buccal, where the enamel is undercut. Instead of opening and removing this enamel, we can block this undercut with composite, and this will give the support to the enamel. An important concept I always explain is that unsupported enamel refers to enamel that doesn't have the support of dentin, and traditionally we'd have to remove this unsupported enamel, but with the biomimetic approach, we understand that composite resin gives the enamel the support it needs so that we don't need to take away more of the tooth structure. As I'm doing this, I'm making sure to not leave any composite on the enamel. I'm just trying to block out the undercut, so I want to clean up the enamel margin as best as I can. And once I'm happy with everything, I'm going to cure this for an additional 10 to 20 seconds. At this point, there's one important step left called air blocking. During the air blocking process, what you're trying to do is remove the sticky, air-inhibited surface of the resin. if you don't remove this air inhibited portion, what happens is the impression materials, a lot of them will not polymerize fully, leaving a swirl pattern behind. And also your temporary will have a really high chance of bonding on permanently. So you want to make sure you do this. And all you have to do is apply glycerin over the entire preparation, cure for an additional 20 seconds, which will allow oxygen to be displaced, and now that air inhibited layer will become polymerized, and now you're finished with immediate dentin sealing. You can take off your isolation, you can go ahead and take an impression and make a temporary. One very important tip I have for you is when you make your temporary, especially if you're using a resin-based material or a bisacryl, to apply some sort of separating agent like Vaseline or glycerin so that your temporary does not lock on or stick on still. You can leave one or two areas that are okay for sticking, or you can make sure that your temporary wraps around the tooth and locks into undercuts, but you don't want it to bond to the immediate dentin sealed layer. And that would conclude your immediate dentin sealing process. Now let's review everything we've learned. In this video, we've covered what immediate dentin sealing is, why it's important, and how to perform it step by step. The technique involves priming the dentin, following with adhesive, using resin coating, using the biobase to eliminate additional preparation, to block out undercuts, to elevate deep areas, deal with deep margins, etc. All of this is in contrast to traditional techniques which rely on more preparation and delayed dentin sealing. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and for more similar content on biomimetic dentistry, please subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions, comment below, and don't forget to turn on notifications by hitting the bell.